Michelle with Cinco Ranch Branch Library. Fall is in bloom, and today I'm going to teach you how to create a fall-themed watercolor note card. Let's begin by discussing the materials you will need for this craft. You will need a 9x12-inch sheet of 140-pound watercolor paper, a number 2 pencil, a ruler, a number 4 or 6 round brush, scissors or a paper cutter, masking tape, a bowl of water, and a set of watercolors. You can get all of these items at your local craft store or super center. The watercolor set that you use can be a beginner set or a more advanced set. It really doesn't matter. What matters is the techniques we're using, and today the techniques are beginners. Your 9x12-inch paper will be marked into 4 sections. The watercolor card is 6 3/4 inches by 10 inches. Your bookmarks or test paper are 6 by 2 1/4 inches at the top and 2 by 6 3/4 inches on the side. I've marked up the sheet of paper with a black marker so that you can clearly see what I have done. I strongly encourage viewers to use a pencil for this step. I've also marked the halfway point on your card so that you will know exactly where to fold. It is at 5 inches. Now, using the paper cutter or a pair of scissors, cut the card and the bookmarks. For our purposes here, let's just cut to the chase. Once everything is cut out, you will use the masking tape to fasten the sides of the card to your table. I eyeballed 1/4 inch on each side. This serves two purposes. First, it keeps your paper from curling up while you're painting. And second, it creates a nice clean border for your artwork. Our card will be made up of 3 maple leaves. You can draw 1 leaf if you like, or you can draw more. I like drawing at least 3. Free artist tip for you, you'll want to avoid drawing an even number of leaves. Your brain wants to automatically divide the objects up evenly. However, it cannot divide an odd number. Therefore, your eye moves around the piece and it makes the artwork more interesting. So let's begin. With your pencil, draw a slight curved line in the center of your paper. At a little more than halfway down, make a V shape like this. Below it, make an inverted V. These are the main veins of your leaf. Now we'll add smaller Vs to each main vein, like this. Next, we are going to outline our veins using a scooping motion. Think of making a jagged U shape or a C shape. Starting at the top and working our way to the center, we will connect after the second smaller V on each main vein. As you can see here, I am going to place my U-shapes as such in order to show where I'm going to be connecting my outlines. Your leaf should look something like this. Don't be upset if your points aren't symmetrical. Remember, this is nature and nothing is even or perfect. Once you've completed your first leaf, feel free to add more leaves using the same techniques. You can place them anywhere and at any angle on your card. As you can see, I have drawn 3 leaves, all at different angles. Now we are ready to paint. When using your watercolors, the lid to your paint palette is used for mixing colors. I'm going to add a few drops of water to my lid. Then with my wet brush, I'm going to pick up some pigment, in this case, yellow, and I'm going to mix it into the puddle of water. I've repeated this process with all the other colors I'll be using. Fall leaves come in a variety of colors, so I have prepared yellow, orange, red, green, and brown. I'm going to start with the yellow and then add some orange to my center leaf. Don't worry about going out of the lines. Now I'm going to add some orange. Notice how I just have to dab the leaf with the orange color and it runs and blends in with the yellow. Afterwards, I will add a few touches of red. Okay, now this is important. While the leaf is still wet and the water has absorbed into the paper, there should be no surface puddles on top of your paper, just a wet leaf. You're going to take the opposite end of your brush and you're going to trace the veins. Notice how the color is going to be drawn into your scraping. Now I'm going to take my red and I'm going to lightly trace the stem. Afterwards, we're going to let the leaf dry completely before adding more color. You can speed up this process by using a hairdryer if you like.
While your leaf is drying, let's talk about where you can get inspiration for your watercolor painting. Take it away, Chaya.
Hi, I'm Chaya at Cinco Ranch Branch Library. So whether you're a beginner or an advanced artist, Pablo Picasso type, or a stick figure artist type, research has shown that creating art is a great way to beat stress. Here at the library, we have a fantastic collection of books on arts and crafts. Want to know where they are? Follow me.
In the art section at the library, specifically those with a call number beginning with 751, you can find books on drawing, watercolor, and pen and ink. Flipping through the pages can help you understand the techniques used in painting and drawing. Don't forget to check out the children's books to be uniquely inspired by adorable illustrations in books. Lots of artists actually use pen and ink washes and watercolor to illustrate children's books. You can also check the photography section for inspirational imagery. Find a book with illustrations you like and try painting one of the scenes yourself.
And that is exactly what I did. I looked through our collection, found a book that was relatively easy to follow. Now this book comes with instructions of what to buy, what type of paints to buy, and also showed me some easy to follow painting techniques. It also came with some projects that I could easily follow. Once I chose my project, it was just a matter of putting my brush to work. The finished product looked somewhat like this. It turned out just fine, don't you think? So come on into the library. Let us show you some books that will surely inspire the inner artist in you. Now back to Michelle for more inspiration.
By now, your leaf should be dry. Wet your brush with your watered pigment and then wet your leaf, leaving the edges of the leaf dry. This is kind of like a reduced outline. You're going to repeat the same steps you did before. So I'm adding my yellow. Notice how I'm not going all the way towards the edge. This is a glaze, and the effect when everything is dry will be really cool. Then I'm going to go in and add my orange and my red. Again, since the yellow was down, the orange and red, you just have to dab and the water allows it to bleed with very little effort.
Remember to scrape the veins with the backside of your brush before the leaf dries completely if your veins seem to be disappearing as you add that second coat of paint. You will not have to do this step when you add the third layer of paint. We are going to repeat this step one more time, making the wet area even smaller. You can start on the other leaves while this second layer is drying. Repeating this process will make the technique easier to remember. Feel free to use different colors for each leaf. As you can see, the leaves on my card are now finished and done in different colors. You can see the glazing technique in the three different layers as we reduce the outline with each color. Now we are going to make a multi-pattern splatter all over the card. First, you're going to load some color onto your brush from your paint lid. While holding your pencil horizontal, you're going to tap your brush on the pencil and splatter the paint all over your card. You're going to use all the colors you used in your painting. You'll want to allow time for this to dry. The last step in making a card will be outlining the leaves with a fine tip black marker. As we remove the tape, notice how it created a clean edged border. And there's your card. You can make matching bookmarks or even take the card and cut it in half, making 2 5 by 6 3/4 inch cards. Then you can take your artwork and glue it onto the colored cardstock that complements your painting. Consider trying other fall themes like pumpkins, candy apples, other leaves, etc. The painting and inking process will still be the same.
For more creative ideas, be sure to check out our Hobbies and Crafts Reference Center database, which you can access for free with the help of your library card. Find that and other sources of inspiration on our website. You can also find more creative crafts videos on our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching and happy painting!